We meet in the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.
And also with you.
Thank you very much. Good morning and welcome to our Eucharist as we celebrate this weekday Eucharist at the High Altar here at Mitcham Parish Church. You're very warmly welcome. As we listen to our Gospel today, we're reminded about finding God in the ordinary, finding God in all those different places where we don't, in a sense, expect Him. We don't expect fireworks every day. God is present with us at all times. And we give thanks for that presence today. So let us pray, use our prayer of preparation to prepare our hearts and minds to worship God. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. My sisters and brothers, as we prepare to celebrate the presence of Christ in word and sacrament, let us call to mind and confess our sins. In the midst of confusion and doubt, we find your grace, O God, and discover your eternal love. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
There is none but you to uphold our cause when our sin cries out and our guilt is great. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Reach out to us, O God, and we shall be healed. Restore us, and we shall sing your praise. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Almighty God, have mercy upon you. Forgive you your sins and bring you to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. So to the collect for this week, the eighth week after Trinity Sunday, let us pray. Almighty Lord and everlasting God, we beseech you to direct, sanctify and govern both our hearts and bodies in the ways of your laws and the works of your commandments, that through your most mighty protection, both here and ever, we may be preserved in body and soul, through our Lord and Saviour Jesus Christ, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
And now pay attention to the readings.
A reading from the book Leviticus. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, "These are the appointed festivals of the Lord, the holy convocations, which you shall celebrate at the time appointed for them. In the first month, on the 14th day of the month, at twilight, there shall be a Passover offering to the Lord, and on the 15th day of the same month is the festival of unleavened bread to the Lord. For 7 days you shall eat unleavened bread. On the first day you shall have a holy convocation. You shall not work at your occupations. For 7 days you shall present the Lord's offerings by fire. On the seventh day there shall be a holy convocation. You shall not work at your occupations." The Lord spoke to Moses, "Speak to the people of Israel and say to them, when you enter the land that I am giving you and reap its harvest, you shall bring the sheaf of the first fruits of your harvest to the priest. He shall raise the sheaf before the Lord, so that you may find acceptance. On the day after the Sabbath, the priest shall raise it. And from the day after the Sabbath, from the day on which you bring the sheaf of the elevation offering, you shall count off 7 weeks. They shall be complete. You shall count until the day after the seventh Sabbath, 50 days. Then you shall present an offering of new grain to the Lord. The tenth day of the seventh month is the Day of Atonement. It shall be a holy convocation for you. You shall deny yourselves and present the Lord's offering by fire. Speak to the people of Israel, saying, on the 15th day of this seventh month, and lasting 7 days, there shall be the festival of booths to the Lord. The first day shall be a holy convocation. You shall not work at your occupations. For 7 days you shall present the Lord's offerings by fire. On the eighth day you shall observe a holy convocation and present the Lord's offerings by fire. It is a solemn assembly. You shall not work at your occupations. These are the appointed festivals of the Lord, which you shall celebrate at times of holy convocation, for presenting to the Lord offerings by fire, burnt offerings and grain offerings, sacrifices and drink offerings, each on its proper day. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response to the psalm is, sing merrily to God our strength.
Sing merrily to God our strength.
Sing merrily to God our strength. Shout for joy to the God of Jacob. Take up the song and sound the timbrel, the tuneful lyre with the harp.
Sing merrily to God our strength.
Blow the trumpet at the new moon, as at the full moon upon our solemn feast day. For this is a statute for Israel, a law of the God of Jacob, the charge he laid on the people of Joseph when they came out of the land of Egypt.
Sing merrily to God our strength.
I heard a voice I did not know that said, I eased their shoulder from the burden. Their hands were set free from bearing the load. You called upon me in trouble, and I delivered you.
Sing merrily to God our strength.
I answered you from the secret place of thunder, and proved you at the waters of Meribah. Hear, O my people, and I will admonish you. O Israel, if you would but listen to me.
Sing merrily to God our strength.
Wisdom in these deeds of power. Is this not the carpenter's son? Is not his mother called Mary? And are not his brothers James and Joseph and Simon and Judas, and are not all his sisters with us? Where then did this man get all of this? And they took offence at him. But Jesus said to them, Prophets are not without honour, except in their own country and in their own house. And he did not do many deeds of power there, because of their unbelief. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
I speak in God's name, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Please make yourselves comfy. It's interesting, isn't it, that reactions to Jesus in his native home underline for us how the mob or the crowd is fickle. One shouldn't put too much stock in its adulation or approval, for we know that the mob or the crowd can change its mind tomorrow. But we also see here the grumbling of neighbours about the apparent pretensions of a local boy. Local lad who's come back, a local from the same background as theirs, who is presuming to teach them and even to dazzle them with some extraordinary works. We know his father, the carpenter, they said. We know his mother and his relatives. They're no better than we are. Then where did this man get all this? And they took offence at him. It's all part of their and our unfortunate tendency to want stupendous signs in the heavens and to be unable to hear God's message when it comes wrapped up in the ordinary. But the teaching of the incarnation, the coming to earth of God's Son, is just this. God is to be found in someone as ordinary as your neighbour's son. Someone who used no flashy displays to get our attention previously, and we so easily forget the presence and availability of our God in the everyday events and people in our lives, that we must remind ourselves of God's presence in other ways. You know, one conclusion we've heard over and over again after the horrors of COVID-19 is about how heroic ordinary people around us were. The healthcare workers, the doctors, the researchers, those who went the extra mile to care for others around them, those who set up food banks, all those heroic acts. They were all around us in the most ordinary seeming people. Now, celebrating here at our Eucharist today the presence of God in the food of everyday life, in bread and in wine, tells us repeatedly that we find God in the simple elements of daily life. We needn't look for God or for heroism or for great generosity in some television spectacular or some cosmic disturbance. For God is at work and present in the people and the circumstances of our ordinary humdrum life. Grace from God may be sitting at the desk next to us at work, maybe standing at that bus stop down the road next to us. They may live next door to us. Grace from God may flow from a sick and demanding member of the family, or from a selfless woman or man carrying out ordinary responsibilities day after day without grumbling or fanfare. After meeting Jesus here today in the words of Scripture, and after spiritually engaging with him as food in the Eucharist, and after engaging with one another, even online, we are prepared to meet him throughout the day, in everyday situations. And that's the meaning of the incarnation. Heaven came to earth. Amen.
Amen.
So in the power of the Spirit and in union with our Lord Jesus Christ, we bring our prayers to our Heavenly Father. Father, we pray for all the Church throughout the world. We pray for Christopher and Richard, our bishops. We pray for Simon, our Archdeacon, and Rachel, our Area Dean. We pray for all the churches in the diocese, particularly those in the Deanery of Merton. We pray especially for the parishes here in Mitcham, St. Barnabas, St. Mark's, St. Olaf's, and this parish church of St. Peter and St. Paul. We give you thanks for our witness as we touch the lives of ordinary people. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we pray for your world, and we give you thanks for the beauty of creation, as we realize that you have made us stewards of this creation. We ask that we may be sensitive to its needs, that we may encourage people to care for our community, to care for our oceans, to care for the air we breathe, to care for the animals, the insects, the fishes, the birds, and all human beings, that we may rejoice in what we regard as the ordinary, that we may see the touch of God in all things, and give thanks and care for it. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we pray for those who are sick or suffering in any way at this time, in body, mind, or spirit. We pray especially today for Danny Gilhooley, Martin Chisholm, Joyce Pennells, Maureen Smith, Astrid Brody, Christina Bryce-Killick, Maurice William, Michelle Chamaret, Claudette, Karen Pugh, Phil Parkinson, Dorothy Cummond Wood, Betty Smith, Paul Barry, and Chika Omunkwo. We pray for those mentioned in our intercessions book. And as we pray, Lord, for those we carry in our own hearts today, we ask that you will be with them and bring them joy in the knowledge of your love. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we pray for those who have died, who have entered the kingdom of heaven. We pray for the souls of Stephen Ryan, Ron Clarkson, Janet Staniecki, and baby Finn James Kennedy. We pray for those whose year's mind falls about this time. We give thanks for all their love, their lives, and their example. Rest eternal grant them, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon them. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Father, finally we pray for ourselves, asking that you will open our eyes to see the extraordinary in the ordinary, that we may appreciate your gifts that you give to your people, that we may be your gift to others. Merciful Father,
accept these prayers
for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. And so to the peace. We are the body of Christ in one spirit. We were all baptized into one body. So let us then pursue all that makes for peace and builds up our common life. May the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Thank you very much. Let's offer one another a sign of peace and pray for those whom we don't see at this current time.
Thank you.
creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine, the work of human hands, it will become for us the cup of salvation. Blessed be God forever. Yours, Lord, is the greatness, the power, the glory, the splendour and the majesty, for everything in heaven and on earth is yours. All things come from you, and of your own do we give you. The Lord is here.
His Spirit is with us.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
Father, we give you thanks and praise for your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your living Word, through whom you have created all things, who was sent by you in your great goodness to be our Saviour. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he took flesh. As your Son, born of the Blessed Virgin, he lived on earth and went about among us. He opened wide his arms for us on the cross. He put an end to death by dying revealed the resurrection by rising to new life. So he fulfilled your will and won for you a holy people. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forevermore praising you and saying,
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Grant by the power of your Holy Spirit, and according to your holy will, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us the body and the blood our Lord Jesus Christ, who in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Same way after supper he took the cup, and again he gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you, for this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. Jesus Christ is Lord. Lord, by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. You are the Saviour of the world. And so, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this hour, sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup. And we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people, and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of Mary, the Mother of God, Peter, Paul, and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. Deliver us from evil.
break this bread, to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. Jesus, Redeemer of the world, give us your peace. Behold, Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his Son. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be. Strengthen for service, Lord, the hands that have taken holy things. May the ears which have heard your word be deaf to clamour and dispute. May the tongues which have spoken your praise be free from deceit. May the eyes which have seen the tokens of your love shine with the light of hope. And may the bodies which have been spiritually fed with your body be refreshed with the fullness of your life. This we ask through Jesus Christ, our Lord, to whom be glory forever. Amen. We pray together. Father of all, we give you thanks and praise, that when we were still far off, you met us in your Son and brought us home, dying and living. He declared your love, gave us grace, and opened the gate of glory. May we who share Christ's body live his risen life. We who drink his cup bring life to others. We whom the Spirit loves give light to the world. Keep us firm in the hope you have set before us, so we and all your children shall be free, and the whole earth live. Praise your name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen indeed, and again a warm welcome to you all this morning as you join us here at the parish church. This is just a little notice to remind you that this evening we're on our Zoom line at 7:30, our Holy Habits group, which is looking again for a second week of poetry and how it leads us into prayer. If you have a poem that you'd like to share, then it would be great if you could let Mary Coggins have a copy of it so that we can actually put it up on the screen this evening to see the words. But please do come along. Last week's was really interesting and really inspiring, and I'm sure tonight's will be the same. So 7:30 on Zoom, finishing before 9 o'clock. So not too long, but a really nice time for fellowship. Our services continue, our open services here in church, at 11 o'clock on Tuesdays and Sundays, and of course we'll be here online again at 10 o'clock this coming Sunday, so we look forward to seeing you there. Meanwhile, keep well and keep safe. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
The peace of God which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you now and always. Amen. Now go in peace to love and to